Hey everybody, welcome to episode 3 of Inside the Triple Llama. My audio interface, which is what I use to get the music data from my instruments to my computer, is not currently working. I do most of my work out here at the kitchen table, and sometimes animals drop by. My interface is currently being repaired by our good friend Tony Shedwick. Thank you, Tony. Originally, I thought that I was going to have to wait until the interface got back. Then I realized this new method of recording, I've only been doing that for maybe 9 months. The 10 years before that, I was using this battery-powered mixer made by Boss. I can't understand 95% of what it does. Supposedly, I can get up to 64 tracks. I've read this thing probably 100 times easily, and I cannot figure out how to get more than 5 tracks. Like, you record the first one, but then you have like 8 ghost ones under it. I don't know. I can record that way because I did it for a long time. So this is my mixer. It is the Boss BR600. It runs on AA batteries, and the songs are stored to flash memory. When I first got this, the card that was in there, I think it had a maximum capacity of 512 megabytes. So if you saw Triple Llama Episode 1, and if you didn't, why not? You know that the way I record acoustic guitar normally is to have 2 tracks recording simultaneously. The first one via a condenser microphone that goes directly into the audio interface, and the other one through my Fishman DI, which is able to shape the tone and then go into a second channel on that interface. We cannot do that with this device for a number of reasons. This mixer does not support phantom power, and it doesn't even have XLR jacks. We've got these quarter-inch jacks here. We've got some RCA jacks. That's how old this is. This is a dynamic microphone. It is less good than the vocal mics that I have been using for the past year, but it still works, and we are able to do that with this adapter, in which connect the XLR to a quarter inch jack and plug that in here. The microphone or microphones go here. Guitar or bass is plugging in directly here. When the device is turned on, I'm gonna hit one of these and move the fader up and then adjust the gain appropriately. I don't know if I am going to attempt to record the acoustic via this microphone, or if I'm going to plug it in directly, which in the past has been a problem. I'm going to try a song called Elsa, which is not about the Disney princess, by a band called Birds Over Arkansas. Elsa is a song that I've loved for a really long time, and I'm going to give it a shot. I don't know for sure if I've got it right. Because it is not a well-known band, I cannot find any tablature or chords for this song anywhere, so I had to do it all by ear. I am going to experiment a little with the settings, and we are going to see if we can figure out which method of recording on this very 90s-tastic equipment is going to work. Okay, see you in a bit!
Fix the verse just in time, reverb at 4 or 5, gotta wrap the new mix by 8 a.m. Drums burst, then the guitar, the wordsmith's working hard to record the best art we can for you. Well, you know what I've been told, you need a full band to run this show. And I can't do this all on my own, but I kinda do, and I'll show you how at the Triple Llama. I can't write a song,
Okay, so we've done a couple things here. First is that my acoustic guitar is plugged in with a quarter inch cable on one end. We're gonna plug the other end into the Fishman DI. Because this acoustic has a very strong signal, like we talked about in episode one, we are actually going to dial the decibel level down and use an attenuator. That is going to go into the back like that. Then we are going to use an XLR to quarter inch adapter. One end is going to go directly into the attenuator, and the other end is going to go there. Now we have to connect the mic. So this dynamic microphone takes an XLR cable, and we have an XLR to quarter inch adapter. We can use this end to plug directly into the mixer's quarter inch mic inputs, plug the XLR end into the mic, then this goes into the mic inputs on this device. Unfortunately, we do need to do one more thing because the input end of the microphone looks like that, and the cable also looks like that. I saw this on eBay one day and I thought, someday I'm gonna use that. This is a female to female connector. So we can do that, and then that, and then that. So now let's turn this thing on. So there is already something on track one. I downloaded a funk drum beat, and we're gonna use that and go to track two. And we're gonna try it first with the microphone. Up here you see guitar selected. We are gonna change that to mic. And then we are going to raise the recording level. We're gonna say halfway. And this is mic one, so we want to change the mic recording level. We'll also say halfway. Let's start the fader maybe there. The effects button is lit. We actually do not want to do that, to do any effects. We are going to record completely dry, so we are going to turn this off. Generally, I try to record acoustic guitars with microphones right around here. Let's try the direct guitar and see how that sounds. Actually, not bad. I don't think we can actually do both the microphone and the direct at the same time, but maybe we can. Huh, what do you know? I pressed the mic and the guitar indicator at the same time, both of them lit up, and so now we are ready to record on both channels 3 and 4. I don't know why it skipped 2, but that's fine, we'll use that for electric guitar later. Success. So now we are going to record the bass. I have selected channel 2. You can see that blinking here. And we're going to plug one end of this cable into the bass and the other end into the guitar bass input. So I'm going to listen to the acoustic guitar track that I've already done and the sample drum track and play the bass along with that. And And I'm going to do one electric guitar. We could do 59 more tracks, but I don't know how this works, and I'm not going to figure it out, honestly, by this point. So I'll do one more, and then I will export the ones that I've already recorded, and then we'll do some more. We're back. That actually worked. I have exported the tracks that we've already done so far to make room, and I combined them all into one file, and now that is my new track one, which I've imported, and I'm starting all over again. I have track two set up. Now it is going to be the second electric guitar track, and I'm going to be able to do all the stuff that I did not get to do the first time. I think probably one main vocal track and one harmony. In a moment deprived, a hope arrived, could not heed the caution. And now, harmony. In a moment deprived, a hope arrived, could not heed the caution. But whatever happens, know that I'm not ashamed of your decision, and you're always welcome home. And let's see, we are going to go to utility, and then tab over until we see USB. And we want to export, because the tracks are on here, we want to get them over to the PC. We can choose one of these two formats. We're going to pick Wave, and now we have to pick which track. We're going to have to do this for all the tracks that are on here. And before I hit enter, I'm going to plug in my USB. Now exporting, and somehow we're done. Recording is done in one day. I think the last time that happened was summer of 2018. This, it turns out, was a good solution. I will send it off to Sean for mixing. But to give you an idea, and this is unmixed, so keep that in mind, this is what all the tracks sound like put together. In a moment deprived, a hope arrived, could not. And it's going to sound better than that, but for now, that's pretty good. Thank you so much, CamannWordsmith patrons, for sponsoring this series. I appreciate it. And we should be back to the normal way of recording audio probably sometime this month. I'm not sure how long the audio interface is going to be out. So, have a great rest of your day, and we will see you next time.